Hi, you're on Public Spot, and this is DevScoops, a rapid show and tell on cloud technology in general in at most 3 minutes. If this tickles your fancy, click the subscribe button. So let's get into it. We learned from the DevScoops episode right here that when you access a website from your machine, be it via your smartphone, tablet, iPad, or laptop, or what have you, your machine communicates with another remote machine, which nowadays is usually somewhere in the cloud. This communication generally involves files being downloaded from the remote machine into your local machine or getting a response back from an API call. If you ever wonder if there's a way to watch these communications happen, the answer lies in the network component of developer tools, which is available in Chrome, Firefox, and Brave. This might be available in other vanilla browsers, but because I'm a Brave user, I'll use Brave in today's show and tell. So, let's start exploring. Before I proceed, please bear in mind that I'm using Windows 10 as my operating system. Also, most of the features in Brave are inherited from Chrome, so what I will be showing today should also apply to Chrome browsers. And to open developer tools in a Brave browser, you open the menu button at the top right corner of the browser, and then select More Tools, and then select Developer Tools. This opens a panel which by default is placed at the bottom of the browser like how we see it now. And to watch the communication that occurs when I access a website, I head to Network tab, which is where we are right now, right here. So for example, I want to see what's involved when accessing YouTube's website. Before I proceed, I need to make sure that the recording is enabled. The red button right here, where my cursor is right now, indicates that my Network tab is recording the activity and this is what I want. So now, I'm going to key in youtube.com on my browser web address bar, like I usually do. As soon as I clicked enter, you start to see rows of logs fly by my network tab. These rows show the chain of calls involved or triggered when accessing youtube.com. And it involves downloading of media and content files like style sheets, as well as API calls facilitated by Google Chrome in the background. So if I scroll all the way to the top of the list and select the topmost entry, and then select the Initiator tab, the data that I get shows the overall chain of calls that happen when I access YouTube's website. There are also useful summary information provided in the footer. So if I close this panel, the footer section of the Network tab shows some very useful information. The first one is the total number of web requests initiated when accessing YouTube's website. The next value is the size of data that is transferred through the network out of all the total requests. And the value next to it is the total number of uncompressed resources loaded to my machine as a result of accessing YouTube.com. The Network tab essentially encapsulates what is happening to make the web application load successfully or not. One of the columns that I find very useful include the status field. Right here. The value of this column maps to the HTTP response status code. So any 4XX or 5XX errors that show up in here usually indicates problems in loading the web application. There's also the size column, which is right here, which indicates the size of the data exchanged between your machine and the remote machine. And then lastly, the time column that accounts for how long the request was sent until a response was received from the remote machine. If I want to mimic a scenario where a user visits the website the first time, I can tick this checkbox right here which says disable cache, and then clear the contents of my network tab, and then refresh this page. This means anything that is cached by my browser as a result of my previous visit to the page will be ignored, and a fresh new set of media and content files are downloaded to my machine. And that's my 3 minutes. Don't forget to click the subscribe button. Until next time, stay safe.